we're going to talk about kidney dialysis. And I know that right now you're probably getting ready to push the button on your TV remote marked, "Dear God, literally anything else." But I promise you, this is worth listening to. While America spends more, by some accounts, than any other nation on dialysis care, we have one of the industrialized world's highest mortality rates. So we're spending the most to essentially get the least. We're basically paying for a fully loaded Lamborghini and receiving a drunk donkey on roller skates. The story of dialysis is an amazing case study of good intentions being thwarted by bad incentives, poor oversight, and profiteering. And one of the key characters in this story is, incredibly, this guy.
Just take those old records off the shelf. I sit and listen to them by myself. Today's music ain't got the same song. I like that old time of rock and roll.
Now, if you are understandably thinking, who is that man doing barefoot gymnastics to Bob Seger while dressed like the third saddest waiter at a medieval times? Well, that is the CEO of DaVita Incorporated.
I almost never refer to patients in the entire thing because it's, for me, it's not about the patients, it's about the teammates. When you're in healthcare, it is nicer, easier, whatever, in the sense that you're actually very directly helping human beings. But that's, to me, that's just not it. If I had 1,400 Taco Bells and 32,000 people who worked in them, I would be doing all the same stuff.
Yes, you heard him right. He just said he manages DaVita, a healthcare company, like he would a Taco Bell, the exact opposite of a healthcare company. A few years ago, the company was sued over accusations it had paid kickbacks to doctors for business. In 2012, a former medical director at a DaVita facility went public with claims about how DaVita treated some of the medicine that it could charge Medicare for. And a separate case accused them not so much of throwing extra drugs into the trash as throwing them into patients. And that involves something called epogen, a medication used to raise a patient's red blood cell count. A whistleblower said that DaVita personnel referred to it as liquid gold. The three cases I have mentioned in the last 5 years have resulted in them paying out nearly $1 billion in settlements. And that doesn't exactly give you confidence in their product.